Spyverse just dropped their second teaser for Sumeru. This one's called Of Rain and Sand. So we might actually see the desert area here, which is very, very early. So let's check it out. Okay. Now we have seen this. Ooh, I like that. Oh.
居民与以往的大版本不太一样，它含有雨林和沙漠两大部分。
Oh, here we go.
在设计过程中要注意的地方非常多。 主要体现的是当地特色、核心主题以及幻想处理这三部分。雨林部分的风貌给人的感受就是山峦连绵的感觉，区别于璃月的柱状形式、稻气的横切硬朗。须弥的山石更加符合热带湿润的地区特征。这种偏柔性轮廓的山石结合古代巨树，贯穿在整个地块。植被方面，我们找了非常多当地特色的植被做参考。 主要体现的是鲜活、生命力、湿润感以及热带特征。沙漠有沙漠风暴、绿洲、渴望水的植被、被风沙侵蚀的岩石、巨大神性、具有历史感的遗迹。
It's like it's not even Genshin.
整体的设计既表现雨林和沙漠的自然魅力，又揉进了很多幻想元素。Massive
like Tomb Raider.
我们一直在尝试设计的边界感，我们不想做非常现实的设计。 也不能过多的放飞,
right.
需要做好异国风情, 幻想度,
以及真实之间的平衡。
各个区域的主视觉同样非常重要, 虚拟的世界设定本身给视觉的多样性提供了非常好的支持, 有各种各样奇幻的内容, 这些内容根据玩家的游玩体验以及美术逻辑安放在各个区域, 这样玩家的视觉感受和情绪变化都会更舒适一些。
Oh my god,
that's
a giant rune guard?
玩家初到这片奇幻森林，会发现一座建立在巨树上的城市。在这片被草神护佑着的国度，你会遇见一群可爱的小精灵。小精灵可是只有小朋友才可以发现它们哦，需要你帮他们解决一系列隐藏在森林深处的危机，才可以获得他们的信任。 在这个过程中，你会发现非常多的未知区域，有长满参天巨树且常年下雨的森林，有因为位置原因导致衰败的森林，也有巨大的伞状发光植物形成的特殊生态区域。在另一片森林中，你还会发现一个巨大的机器人残骸在山体和壁之间。在这些奇幻森林的背后，似乎正在被一股神秘的力量侵蚀着。 从须弥城向西望去，可以隐约看到须弥的沙漠区域。在这里，你会发现颠倒浮空的神秘遗迹和冲破天际的龙卷风。What
the heck?
看似一望无际的沙漠下面，同样隐藏着非常多的探索区域。沙漠深处也有一个巨大的机器人。
I don't like these robots, man.
那这个机器人和森林的机器人又有什么关系呢？森林的神秘力量又来自哪里呢？ 就请旅行者去探索发现真相吧。
All right, well, yeah, I mean, it looks amazing so far. I like the desert, you know? The desert area looks so, it's so different for Genshin, you know? Like, it doesn't even seem like it's Genshin, you know? It, like I said, it reminds me of Tomb Raider. It reminds me of, like, you know, the other, like, single-player games that I've played with, like, vast areas and different types of, you know, like, regions. I like how there's also areas where they don't look all, you know, extravagant. Like, there's, like, swamps and whatnot, you know, like, places where the trees are all, like, you know, the trees are half dead. It's all dark. The water's, like, dirty, you know? But, I mean, just look at that, man. Oh, my gosh. And they tried to, like I said, get a mixture of realism and fantasy at the same time. They showed, like, in comparison to Liyue, you know, with Liyue, you gotta climb all those really, really tall mountains and whatnot. For Sumeru, you know, we're going to be climbing, of course, but he said that it was more like a, yeah, like this, like, you see, it's endless mountains, you know, so it's just like kind of all going up at one point instead of there being a bunch of different pillars. And also here, she mentions that she says you'll meet a group of adorable little spirits that only children can see. Just help them solve a series of crises hidden in the depths of the forest. So that might be like a world quest or something in the future there. She also mentions that some of the trees have withered for some unknown reason. Guess we'll find out when we get there. They definitely look a lot weirder than just like withered trees, but yeah. So there's that, and she also mentions a Dungeon of Archon. And then not once but twice she mentions the giant robot. So hopefully that thing doesn't come alive. But there's two giant robots. There's one in the forest area and one in the desert area. It looks very, very old and ancient, but you know, we never know what's gonna happen with that. So you know how they like to show things and tease us. So she says, look west of Sumeru City and you'll be able to see the desert area of Sumeru. And then she says, you'll find a mysterious ruin floating upside down and tornadoes tearing through the sky. I don't know what that's about. I really do not. So either way, I'm excited. This is gonna be insane. But that'll be all for me. I'm super excited to see this. This is only trailer number two. We have about 31 days till Sumeru comes out, so about a month and some change. But I hope you guys are all well. I will catch you guys in the next one.